towards sternum, keeping the low back neutrally aligned. Yes, so there'll be a little dip in your low back. So inhale, expand your belly. As you exhale, wrap and then lift your right arm forward, left leg back into a long line. Inhale, we bring those points down. Exhale, wrap and then lengthen arm and leg up. Inhale, we lower. Exhale, wrap and lengthen. So that there is a little bit of this like advanced focus. We're kind of one step ahead with our abdominals before we move our limbs. So big inhale. Exhale, then move. Okay, keep that going. It's like you're balancing a full glass of water on your low back, and it ain't moving. Great. And in. All right, guys. Do one more each way. Inhale. And then exhale. Okay, cool. So just the left leg up towards the ceiling, flexing the foot. You're gonna pull the knee towards you, open it out to the side, and then circle it up back to the start. Knee floats down, knee opens up to the side, and then take it right back up to that 90. Two more this way. Really see if you can shift your weight a little bit towards the left side. And now let's reverse that direction. So knee, thigh bone opens up to side, knee drives in, and then back up. So really feel the stirring sensation, big circles being drawn inside of the left hip socket joint without disturbing anything else. Good. And then one more. Picking it on up and little pulses up for 8 and 7. And really feel the pulses happening right where your seat meets that. 2 and 1, release. Cool. Okay, so now shift. Exhale, right leg lifts up towards ceiling. Flex the foot. Let's draw the knee in, out to the side, and then right back up. And as that thigh bone is circling deep inside the hip socket, make sure if you look down at your inner thigh of your left thigh should be vertical. Yes? One more time this way. And then let's reverse. Knee opens outwardly, drives down and back up. As the thigh bone is moving, we're trying to keep the pelvis nice and level. Open, so you might need to slow it down. One more time. Lift that leg up behind you and pulse, and pulse. Little softness through the elbow joints. We got 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring those knees right back down. Okay guys, walk your forearms down onto the mat. So elbows directly underneath the shoulders, legs long behind you, and you got this beautiful long line from the crown of your head out through your feet. Okay, so you got your plate, and as you're on your forearms are parallel to one another, heels squeezing together. Pull your elbows to your toes and hold. See if you can feel your navel drawing up towards your sternum, keeping your hips nice and level to the floor. Shoulders pulling down your back. Energy in through the midline of your body, so squeezing the heels together. Head reaching away from your feet. Hold there for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring those knees down. Press back off of your arms into a little bit of a child's pose here. Alright, so we're going to go right into a side lying position. So you're going to lie down onto your left side, and one of your little weights into your top hand, okay? So my bottom knee is bent, and my top knee is bent as well. Both of my legs stacked together, my heels in line with my tailbone, and my bottom waistline is hovering off the floor. My top hand pushes my top hip away from me. And that makes sure that my pelvis is stacked. Now my little weight that's in my hand is going to rest on top of the thigh. Yeah, top thigh. So you're gonna big inhale in. As you exhale, lift your top knee off the bottom knee, keeping your feet together. Close, lift, lower, lift. All the while, as this knee is moving in and up, we are maintaining a neutral alignment with within our spine, which means that the low bottom waistline on that side is staying lifted off the mat. You can easily slide your fingers underneath. I lower my knee and I lift. Now as we're going into this clam position, I want you to start by moving that thigh slowly, smaller than you'd like. And notice if your hip is coming along for the ride. It should not, it should stay still. It's just the thigh bone moving. Now I have about 3 pounds resting on top of my thigh, so it's just enough to give my little side seat a little bit of a wake-up call. You can definitely do this without any weight. We've just added a bit of spice to that side seat. Lift, lower, and lift. Okay, so you got a lot of sequence here in our side lying position. Keep it going, guys. You got 3 more. 2, and then final one. Hold that knee up in tiny pulses, up and up. So you'll notice my feet are still together. I'm still thinking of sticking my butt back and my bottom waistline is hovering off mat. It might feel, if you're joining, it might look like we're not doing much. Oh, but we are. You got 4, 3, 2, last one, and lower the knee down. Okay, take the weight off. Press the hand into the floor as you lift your feet off the ground for a bit. And then from there, same thing goes with the leg, but this time our feet are hovered. Now you can feel free to rest the ball on top of that thigh again, or just don't worry about it, keep the hand on the floor. So lift and lower. So my feet are still connected, but they're off the floor. Nice. And as I externally rotate and then back together, I feel for the heat through the side of the seat. And you should too. All right, next one, hold the knee up, and then you're gonna separate your feet, knees tap, toes tap, knee and toe. So now the top leg kind of has its solo moment here, where it really dances through mid-air. As your thigh is moving, I know the hips really wanna get involved, but don't let them. Yes, down and up. This is 6, 5. Daisy, you got 4 more left of these. How's the fire there? 2, 1 more. Fantastic. Lower the feet, bring the knees back in. Okay, so extend your top leg out long. So now the leg is out, away from you, and it's in a long lengthened position. And you're gonna circle the thigh up and around. Circle. So I decided to have my foot flexed. So I'm pulling all my 5 toes, the top of my foot, towards the same side shin. As we circle the thigh, guys, making sure that we explore the back edge of the circle. Keep it going. Lift. And think of hip height maybe a little bit higher. And circle. Woo! Nice. And then let's reverse. Think like tennis ball size shape, no bigger than that, really make it small, and see if you can feel the hips staying still and the bottom waistline still hovered. That's it, everybody. 4 more. 3, 2, and 1. Bend the knee in towards your chest, kick it right back out to start position. Bend the knee in towards you, kick it right back out. Bend. Good. So as the knee is bending, make sure that the hips stick back. Yeah, so that the low back isn't round. It stays exactly as neutrally possible. In and extend. Nice. I should see some hearts floating up right about now because we feel a love in the side of the hip. Press the leg long. Let's go for 3 and 2. All right, 1 more. We're gonna go into a thing called the hills and valleys. We start with the hills. So you're gonna point your toe, lift the leg up, and then tap it in front of you, and then lift, tap the leg back. Yeah, I see some hearts flying, so good. Up and forward, tap, up and back, tap. So this is your hill, so the leg is going all the way up and over the hill, and then all the way up and over the hill, we go forward. So keep that going. The toe does not have to touch the floor. it around. Nice, guys. All right, let's do four more of these. Four and three, two, one more. Now we go into our valley. So the leg is going to dip forward and out, and I have my foot flexed, and then my leg sweeps down and up. So tracing like a happy smile, yeah? Down and up. That's how we're feeling right now as we do this. Sweep back and up. Now as that leg is moving forward and back, just make sure that all your five toes are facing forward. You can even play around with perhaps turning them down a little bit more. But we definitely don't want those toes to start pointing up at this point. Lift and out. Keep it going, guys. Let's go for four and three, two, and one more. Come all the way back to center. Reach the leg out long and little pulses. Take the top arm, reach it up towards the ceiling. Can you get a little bit lighter off through the lower back or through the lower half of your side waist here? Okay, can you get that leg a little longer? Let's go for six, five, four, three, two, and one. Release. Good. Give it a little bit of love, a little snackaroo. You're going to lie right onto your back. So that was my right leg that was lifted. And now as you roll onto your back, make sure it's the same leg that was just up that is rooted into the floor. So my right foot will stay. My left knee is well over top of my left hip, tabletop. So I take a big inhale. As I exhale, I push into my right foot and I lift my hips up. And then I lower down to a hover. Exhale, I lift my hip. Inhale, I hover. Exhale, I lift. Inhale, I hover. Nice. So the beauty about this single leg bridge is we get the spice now from the side of the hip right into the back of that same cheek. Yeah. If one leg up is too much for you, please bring your left foot down. You got 2 feet. You want your knee to be well over top of the heel, yes? And push into the right heel to get your hips up higher. Now, as you're lifting your hips, make sure that the hip is level. So whatever leg is up, so that was my left leg that was up, I'm thinking left hip a little higher than my right hip to make sure that the pelvis stays level. Yeah, so keeping that going. Exhale, lift. Inhale to lower, hover. You can let me know how it feels afterwards. And if you're watching this on a couch or whatever, maybe you can be like, whoa, what does it look like? Does it look easy? Because it sure doesn't feel easy. Hold this last one up and tiny pulse and pulse and pulse. Use that right foot, guys. Root into the floor. Backs of the arms assist as well. I got 8 more taps here. 8, 7, 4. Last 2, 1, hold. Lower the left foot and lower the hips right on down. Good. Send your arms out to a T with your palms facing up and bring your legs up to tabletop position. Squeeze the legs together. Feet slightly above the knee line. Shoulders stay on the floor. You're going to tip your knees over one way and then center. Tip your knees to the opposite way. And then center. Tip your knees one way and center. Tip your knees the opposite way. Nice. So exhale one direction. Inhale to return center. Exhale in the opposite direction. Make sure that you're feeling grounded through the shoulder blades. As we tick-tock our legs side to side, feel for those obliques. Waistline working. All right, guys. Keeping that going. So the lower portion of your spine is moving. Let's do one more each side. Good. One last one here. And then bring your hands behind your knees. Nod your chin. Roll yourself up to seated. Flip over onto hands and knees before we take it to the other side. And your hands are going to be just as wide as your shoulders. Actually, a little bit wider than that. And you're going to sit on your left hip with your right and your left knee pointing towards the right side of your mat. Your knees are bent. I'm going to turn my head, look towards you guys with my left ear to the mat. I bend my elbows. My toes are tucked under. I'm going to take a deep inhale here. As I exhale, I press my body up And I sweep my knees to the left. I turn my head to the left. Bend my elbows. Everything lowers down. Exhale. Rotate. Bend the elbows all the way down. Exhale. Pick up. And I try to get my head, my ribs, and my hips and knees up at the same time. That's tough. Keep it going. Exhaling. Lift. Rotate. Look to the left. Press up. All right, let's do one more each way. Exhale, lift, rotate, and lower one more time. Press up and lower. All right, well, so now you should be sort of in a position where you can sweep your legs around to the second side. So now my left leg is going to be on top. I'm lying on my right side completely. And my little weight is handy. My legs are stacked, my feet are together, my heels are in line with the tailbone, bottom waistline is lifted, little weight rests on the thigh. So I take a deep inhale, nothing happens. As I exhale, I pick up the top knee off the bottom knee, feet stay together. Inhale, lower, exhale, out. Nice. And just like that, we are on the other side. So a little bit more chill today as, you know, not so much up, down, up, down, up, down. We're going to save that for next week. But even though it's, I say chill, it really is just more so focused on maintaining the beautiful alignment through spine as your thigh is moving. It's not easy. It's not chill. It's actually a lot of work. If you're doing it correctly, that means that bottom waistline is covered or spine is staying nice and neutral. So imagine like you were standing, yeah? Your spine is vertical. So we don't want to let the bottom waistline drop so that we're not standing crooked. Yeah? Front hip crease is creased because our butt's sticking back behind us. And we're maintaining that neutral alignment through the lower back. We exhale the leg up. There's a little bit of weight restricting the leg movement, a touch, yeah? Exhale, we lift. Inhale, lower. All right, let's do two more. Hold this next one up, and just take a small and gentle pulse up and down. So think like a millimeter down, focusing on the lifting part, fighting against gravity, and feeling that heat starting to build up through the side of your top hip. That's it, guys. Let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2, and slowly lower. So I'm going to release my weight. I'm going to lift my feet off the floor without changing anything through the spine, through the pelvis. And then I'm floating my top knee up, and then I lower down. I exhale, and I inhale, return. So same bit of movement that we just did, but this time with our feet elevated. If you feel much more comfortable with your feet down, please do. Just go back to that level. Yeah, you can always regress to it. So by just a show of maybe hearts, if your tablet or your phone is nearby, how much do you feel in your side seat? Maybe some hearts will pop up. Maybe if the phone is close to you or your tablet's close, don't worry about running to go and do that. You know, so there's some hearts. Good. Opening and closing. Okay, this one we're going to keep the knee up. Oh, look at that, more hearts. So you're going to go knee and toe. Knee and toe. So that top leg is dancing. Yes, the hearts are flying. That means it's a working. Enjoy this, guys. Yes. Probably for the rest of the day, you won't feel so guilty sitting on these hips because they've been worked on. I know a lot of you are very active and everyone's running around and enjoying themselves and then treating themselves to a little bit of hip love here on a Sunday at 1 at Sweat and Tonic. All right, guys, let's do two more. 2 and up one more time. And then we bring everything on down. Okay, so my bottom knee stays bent. My top leg extends out long. And I start to circle the leg up and around. Nice and slow. Remember that it is about a tennis ball sized circle, so it's not too big. And really send your bottom waistline off. Make sure that the ribs stay drawn in and down. Think navel towards sternum. Good, and then let's reverse the direction of the circle up and around. Imagine as if someone is holding onto your top leg and is pulling the leg away from your top shoulder. Nice, that's it guys. Let's go for 3, 2, and 1. Pause there, bend your knee towards you, kick the leg back out. Bend the knee in, extend the leg back out. Inhale, exhale, lengthen. Inhale, exhale, lengthen out. So every time the knee bends towards you, watch that you're not sinking your bottom waistline into the mat. Really feel how much those abdominals are working, even though it looks like we're not doing much. There's a lot happening there to keep our pelvis and spine stable. Nice, let's do 2 more. Last one, here come our hills and valleys. So foot is pointed for our hills. Forward, up, and back. Summertime. How y'all doing, guys? It's good to play here with you every Sunday at 1 o'clock. Tell your friends, bring them all together. We can all move together here as a team. We always think about you guys here at Sweat and Tonic. Making sure you're checking out all the schedules here on our online platforms. Because there's a lot of good stuff coming your way all week long. Some new classes too. You gotta check out that schedule. Alright, so last one here in our hills. And then the flexed foot will bring us into our valley. Sweep the leg forward, down, and back. So I'm really working on trying to keep my thigh bones parallel. So my toes and my knee joint, my kneecap, is facing forward. I focus a lot of my attention on the reaching back as the leg lifts. Just to explore the back edge and feeling a little bit more lift, not just through the side of my seat, but as well as where my seat meets my hamstring, right in the back there. Nice, let's do 1 more. And then find the side and little pulses up. And up. Send the top arm up and see if you can reach the top hip away from you a little bit more as the leg gets longer. 6, 5, ribs are in. 3, 2, 1, and release. Woo! All right, lie on your back. Left foot is grounded, right leg is up at table unless you need that foot down. Remember the knee is well over top of the heel. Arms by your side. Inhale as you exhale. Press into the left foot. Lift your hips. Inhale, lower to a hover. Exhale to lift. Inhale to hover. And now as my right knee is stacked over my right hip, my energy remains the same as if I had 2 feet on the floor. The energy out of my knee joint remains the same. Not just through my left leg, but as well as into my right knee. So my right knee is energizing up towards the ceiling as my left knee energizes across the opposite end of the room. Looking down at your right hip and feeling for that hip to elevate a slight bit more than left to keep you level. Feel the summertime in the left butt cheek. 2 more. Hold your hips up in tiny pulses. Lift, lift. Stay long through the arms. Root down to the left heel a little bit more. Let's go for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower the foot, lower the hips. Give your knees a squeeze. Rocking side to side, everyone. All right, take your hands behind your knee joints, nub the chin, roll on up. Sweep your legs around, let's find our high plank position. So hands are in front of you, armpits over the wrists, step your right foot back long, followed by your left. All right, so keep your legs together, squeeze your heels together, pike your hips up, look at your toes, shift forward as you exhale. Inhale. at our feet. And then we shift forward and up. Next one will be a little different. Hike and hold. So really round your spine. Think like you're doing a cat. So pulling your ribs up. Look right up to your belly button. Think pubic bone towards the nose. And start to roll yourself all the way on out into a long line plank. From here, reverse that so the chin tucks in. You start to lift up through the backs of the shoulders, back of the ribs, low back, tailbone, lengthen. And then nod the chin, do that again, pubic bone towards nose, and roll yourself on out as you keep those heels squeezing. And then last one here, nod the chin, pull up through the back of the ribs, mid back, low back, tailbone, lengthen. All right, just shift yourself forward into the plank. Separate your feet hip width apart. Draw your right knee towards the right elbow. Swoop it to the left. Circle down and back. Again, knee goes across to the right, down left, and step it back. One more, out to the right elbow, left elbow, step it back. Reverse that, three in the opposite direction. Three, out and back. Two, head can sort of turn and follow where the knee is going. Good. And then pike your hips up, try to look through the heels right in them. Shift yourself forward into plank. Left leg. Left knee to the outside of the left elbow. Cross under right. Step back. Two more. So think of a nice circular pattern with the left knees. Almost like tracing a teardrop. Reverse. Cross under, open side, back. Two more. Meanwhile, the opposite leg is staying strong and long. Step back, pluck your hips up. Keeping your heels nice and heavy as you walk your hands towards your feet one by one. Bend the knees. Roll yourself all the way up to standing tall. Good, take your feet underneath your hips. Big inhale, lift up. Sweep your left arm under as you tip over one way. And center, switch, and up. One more each direction. Reach up, and center. Last one. Good, bring your arms out to a T. Give yourself some love. Awesome job. Thank you so much for coming. Have a fantastic and a fabulous rest of your Sunday. As always, I'm here 1 o'clock every Sunday. I'm also here on a Thursday at 10 a.m. It's a new class. It's a bar class. Who's coming? I'll be there. Guys, thank you. Thanks, Bob. Thanks, Sharon. Enjoy the sunshine. It's a little cooler here in Toronto, so enjoy sort of that spring weather that we've missed that should have been here in April, but is now here in almost June. Happy almost June. Yes, you're welcome, Denise. Enjoy those hips. Kiki, nice work. High five, everybody. Yes, Kara. Kara the Explorer, love it. Yeah, Fit Bean. Woohoo, Allie, you're welcome. Thank you, pleasure, guys. I'm Fitkowski here on Instagram. If you wanna touch base, reach out. If you have any questions, Sweat and Tonic, we've got you. Take it easy, I'll see you guys on the other side. Bye. Thanks again.